वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू क्लास क्लास इन क्लास 12 सी द चैप्टर इज प्लान डेवलपमेंट इन दिस चैप्टर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट आफ्टर द इंडिपेंडेंट व्हाट आवर इंडिया प्लानिंग फॉर द इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंडिया यू नो क्लास इंडिया वॉज गॉट इंडिपेंडेंस on 15 August 1947 and after this India was faced three challenges. First challenges for nation building, second challenges for establish a democracy and the third challenges ensure the economic development or you ensure the development of disadvantaged group, you can say not only the well-being of society of some section but all the section, especially disadvantaged group. So third challenges was after the independence was the economic development. So after the independence, when this challenges was come for the economic development, our leaders were this planning for a development class. From your chapter you are looking ki some in the world the demand of steel was increased, and when the demand of steel was increased in all over the world, you know the Odisha was a state where too much iron ore was trapped under the earth. So state of the Odisha government was taking this opportunity, and the Odisha government was signed a memorandum of understanding between their state and international communities, and also for a domestic companies. So Odisha government was signed a memorandum of understanding, and government of Odisha was wanted to take the advantage of this opportunity, and government of Odisha was want to investment in their state. Technology will come, investment is come in their state, and people got the employment. So the government was very hopeful for these investment, and this will accelerate the economic development of Odisha. And some at the same time, some peoples who are living near the forest or under the forest were worried about this ki government was going for mining in the Odisha, and most of the minerals and or you can say iron ore was under the forest, and when the government was going to take this iron ore from the earth, so first of the thing is that ki they cut the trees, and this was damage the environment, and second thing, the peoples who are living near the forest, tribals communities were also displaced. So this was a big problem ki what the government, what should a गवर्नमेंट टू बी डन, क्या करना चाहिए. तो वी हैव ऑप्शन टू कंसल्ट विद इकोनॉमिस्ट और कंसल्ट विद द इन्वायरमेंटलिस्ट कि कैन दिस एक्टिविटीज गुड फॉर द इन्वायरमेंट, और डिस्कस विद द tribals communities whose welfare was ignored, तो दिस वॉज अ बिग चैलेंजेस फॉर द उड़ीसा गवर्नमेंट कि दे टेक द मिनरल्स फ्रॉम द अर्थ एंड इट वॉज अ ग्रेट कॉस्ट इट डैमेज द एनवायरमेंट इट डिस्प्लेस द ट्राइबल्स कम्युनिटी सो दीज कंट्राडिक्शंस and at the same time it will increase accelerate the economic growth of Odisha it provide the opportunity for economical investment technology will come in the state of Odisha so what can the government decide government kya karna chahiye this was a big challenge and the If government was saying no because peoples were displaced, environments were damaged, if the government is say, the central government was not with the state government's decision for no. Because this gave a negative message in the international community ki India not encouraged the investment. India's policy was not liberal. So state central government was also very careful central government was also want investment in the Odisha because it is an investment of money technology will come employment is produced by this production so class Ultimately, it was decided ki the decision was left on the government. The decision was left on the our representative, which are elected by the peoples, and the political our public representative will take the decision about this investment. And government should be participate in their decision making of the peoples it will be good for any plan and it will also ensure the success of a plan if a government will discuss with the people about their implement because when the government was make any plan it was necessary to contact to the people government should be contact to the people before implementation and if the peoples will agree with the implementation then the government should implement it otherwise the tension and contradictions will create and ultimately the plans was fail so these things are very important and class after the independence what will the idea of development there are some leaders who want to development on the basis of they like the modernization means to follow the path of the western countries of liberal democracy and capitalism they follow the idea of modernization means to follow the western countries and their industrialization so this was a question कि आफ्टर द इंडिपेंडेंट इंडिया शुड फॉलो अ कैपिटलिस्ट मॉडल ऑफ इकोनॉमी और सोशलिस्ट मॉडल ऑफ इकोनॉमी तो दिस इज अ बिग क्वेश्चन अमॉन्ग द लीडर्स हु आर टेकिंग द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट एंड सोशल जस्टिस एंड वेलबींग ऑफ द पीपल तो क्लास मॉडर्नाइजेशन वॉज ऑल्सो लिंक विद द रैशनल थिंकिंग progress and growth and many things are linked with the development you know class on those days there was two models are very popular US model and SSR model US models is the you know as a capitalist model they follow the liberal democracy it means the state can give the relaxation for the businessman for the free competition for to earn profit and make the private property so first model was the capitalist model which was followed by the America and the Western countries. So should India follow the US model? Some our important leader want to India should be follow the capitalist model of US, because India is a democratic country and USA is pro democracy. So India should be follow the capitalist and liberal democracy. But some leader in our India, they want to SSR model of socialist model, and they want the plan economy. They want to they make the 5-year plan for the economic development of a country. And you know, our Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was also like the socialist model. But in 1955, in the Congress session in the Adani, the Congress was declared their manifesto is the program was the socialist pattern of economic development. Congress was announced the policy of India. India was using a 5-year plan, and class you know, in 1944, so many big industrialists were come together, and they were design a plan, and they recommended were that ki after the independent planning of the economic development should be in the state control. And in 1944, the industrialists were make a plan for the economic development of India. This plan is known as Bombay Plan, and they want to economy which was under the control of state at the initial stage. And after all, plus after the independent India was decided ki India was not the socialist nor the capitalist. India was adopting the mixed economy. Okay, class, with the help of private sectors and with the help of government sector, both are come together for the economic development of a country. And the Indian government was decided ki, you know, the era of 1940 to 1950, this era was a Second World War era, and most of the economy of the world was suffering, and this time was the recession, the economies of the world are suffering. So during this session, this season, this time is also related to Second World War. Most of the European countries was involved in the restructuring of their economy. So on that time, there was a common view that country should be adopted a state control economy. State can interfere for the economic development of a country. So after the independent India was also decided that initially the model of planned economy, the model of economic development was not left on the hand of private players, but model of development was under the control of state at the initial stage. Class, when India was got the independent, so it was decided ki India was adopted the state control model of economic development, and India was adopted a mixed economy. Means both state control and private players are allowed for development. And initially our government was also started and making the 5-year plan for the economic development. you know, class there was a budget where the all the income and expenditure of a country was write down in a budget. Their plan and non-plan budget. Plan budget for the plan budget for 5 years, and their priority was primarily fixed, and second is non-plan budget. Means this on the yearly basis the expenditure was decided. Okay, so our Indian economy, our planning was a mixed economy. Both private and the public, both players are allowed in the production. Okay, when the private players were mostly working in urban area, so the state government was trying to go in the rural area. So by both public and private, both sector were contributed the development. Class 5 year plan was introduced to follow the USSR or Indian economy was going for a plan development, like a first 5 year plan, second 5 year plan, and a class in December 1951. Our first 5 year plan was released, and this plan was welcomed by media, by journalists, by freedom fighters, by politicians, by economists, employees, and so many people were very excited during the first 5 year plan. Okay. After the first 5 year plan, second 5 year plan was introduced. Class, you know, what is the difference between the first 5 year plan and second 5 year plan? Because class, in first 5 year plan was focused on the agriculture sector. In the first 5 year plan, the rate of the economic growth was very slow because it is a danger for our Indian. So initially the rate of economic growth was very slow, and but in the second 5 year plan, which was focused on the industrialization, and at the time of second 5 year plan, the economic growth has become very fast. Plus, in first 5 year plan, the government was focused to increase the irrigation. They set up dams, canals, and ensured the accessibility of water for irrigation facility. So in the first 5 year plan, the government was focused on the irrigation facility for the production of food grains. Similarly, in the second 5 year plan, which was based on the industrialization, the government was spending too much money to establish different industrial institute. Government was also decided ki taking decision ki we should encourage the agriculture sector or industrial sector. Someone saying ki we should focus on the agriculture because we are country suffering from the food grains, so we should be self independent on the food. And someone saying we have a need to industrialize and focus on the industries, because they create employment and their products are using in our country and world community, so they also provide the jobs. So there was a different view of the, from the different leaders, and similarly there is a differences ki jo economy hai state control honi chahiye, soviet model apnani chahiye, socialist model, capitalist model we should apnana chahiye, ki we should apnaye, we should adopt a capitalist model, we should adopt a socialist model and communist, or we should adopt the capitalism and liberal democracy. So this was a question, and India was decided to choose a path of mixed economy, and Indian government was using both for the country's development. Plus, after all, we are talking about what are the outcomes, major outcomes, what are the major outcomes. Class, there was no lack in the planning, but the aim was not fulfilled. What was the reason? Because the plan was the very good, but it was only on the paper. It will not properly implement. So there was a classes, because most of the people who were engaged in the planning, they were itself land owners. So the plan was very good, but it was on paper. It was not properly implemented, because the makers were itself jamidars, landlords. So these economical plans were not fulfilled our aspiration and our needs. So class, now come on the what are the major outcomes. Plus, first thing, the foundation. Our government was established dams, so many hospital industries were set up, many infrastructures, roads were set up, and rail transport were also improved. After this planning to accelerate the trade and commerce, and we will try to reduce the poverty and employment in the nation. We will also try to collect the small pieces of land to merge them for a land reform. The land should be suitable for the agriculture, and our government was trying to land reform. And the next foundation was the green revolution, outcomes of green revolution. And next outcomes, green revolution, which means we will become self-independent in the field of agriculture. We produce sufficient food grains for the fulfill our desires. We are using the green revolution. We use the HYB seeds, pesticides, and chemical fertilizers. We are use the modern weapons of irrigation to increase the productivity, and by this we will become a food independent country by the green revolution, to produce surplus production of wheat and rice. We will focus on basically big landholders. So our government was using giving some support to big landlords to produce more food grains. Thank you, class. class, our government was also trying to become to increase the production of milk by white revolution. Our government was introduced operation flats and increase the productivity of milk to make our country self independent on the food. And after some time our country become self sufficient on the food.